Hello and welcome to McGill Martlet Volleyball tonight on SSN Canada. I'm Riley Wayman, and I'm here with my broadcast partner, Chris Wilhelm, at McGill's Love Competition Hall, getting ready for the start of the McGill Martlets matchup against their crosstown rivals, Les Carabins de Montréal. The Martlets are coming off of a hard-fought 3-1 loss to Laval Rougeau in Quebec City on January 15th. Despite 10 kills and 9 kill performances from Kelsey Irwin and Emily Kite, respectively, McGill could not match the power of the number 3 ranked Laval squad. When asked about the Martlets' performance, head coach Rachel Béliveau said, "Overall, we had some good sequences, but they hit much harder than we did, and we were unable to match their speed. But the rest of their game was comparable to ours, so we know where we have to improve when we meet them in the playoffs." Last week marked another milestone for the Martlets as they finally cracked the CIS top 10 after their 3-1 win over Sherbrooke. If the Martlets are able to win tonight over Les Carabins, the Martlets will secure the third and final playoff berth ahead of last place Sherbrooke. Les Carabins de Montréal entered tonight's game with a 13-3 record after a come-from-behind win against Sherbrooke, winning the match 3-1 after losing the first set 24-26. Winning tonight's game, and depending on the outcome of the Laval-Sherbrooke matchup, could move Les Carabins into a tie for first place with Laval in the RSEQ standings. And now over to Chris after the anthem. And now we'll go over to Chris with the keys to the game.
Thanks, Riley. My name is Chris Wilhelm, and I'll be going over the keys to the game for our teams tonight. First off, for McGill, the first key to a successful match for the Martlets tonight is to step up their game defensively. Statistically, McGill is the worst team in the league for allowing the most kills, assists, aces, blocks, and digs by opponents. The Montreal Carabins boasts some of the best offensive numbers in the league, and will punish the Martlets if McGill is unable to put up some solid defense. The second key for the Martlets tonight is to try to take control of each set early and to go into the technical timeouts with the lead. The Martlets tend to play a much stronger game all around when they are defending the lead, and it will be very important to stop the Université de Montréal squad from gaining any early momentum. And for the Université de Montréal, our first and only key to the game tonight for this squad is to continue their dominating offensive play. The Carabins boast ownership of the league leader position in kills, hitting percentage, assists, and blocks. If Montreal stays on their game tonight, there is little chance that the defensively struggling Martlets will be able to cope. We're just about ready for our match tonight, folks, as we hear our starting lineups.
Dominating on that ball.
So the starting lineup for your McGill Martlets tonight, if you were unable to hear that, is Emily Kite, Victoria Pelletier, Marcella Mansour, Kelsey Irwin, Genevieve Plante, Kaiva Mateus, and the libero is Daphne Maud André Morin. The starting lineup for Laval is Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon, Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc, Maud Ménard Houillette, Mélanie Roy, Pamela Drapeau, Marie-Sophie Nadeau, and Annie-Claude Pellerin is the libero. Sophie Bergeron will now serve for Les Carabins. And it's good, picked up by Victoria Pelletier. And Kelsey Irwin with a hammer off of the block. And a big spike there coming from Marie-Sophie Nadeau as she takes that one to the 5-6 seam.
In the last game against that the Carabins played against McGill, Marie-Sophie Nadeau had an astounding 24 kills. She's definitely going to hope to put up a similar performance tonight.
And the service is good, picked up by Emily Kite. And the attack goes just wide. Genevieve Plante was unable to catch the line on that one. Sophie Bergeron still serving for Les Carabins. 2-0. And her jumper's good. Picked up by Emily Kite. And a back set there for Genevieve Plante. And she catches the libero in some confusion there and gets the point for McGill. The setter, Marcella Mansour, will now serve for the Martlets. 1-2. Picked up by the libero. And a big set for Nadeau, and she takes it off of Marcella Mansour's hands. It hit the antenna, so it was out. And Marcella Mansour will serve again for the Martlets. Two serving two. And her long floater goes just wide as the Les Carabins take a 3-2 lead.
Good call by the Carabin libero to just let that one soar on by.
Pamela Drapeau will now serve for Les Carabins. She lines up for her jumper. And it's good to the 5-6 seam. Big set for Kelsey Irwin, and she puts a little tip over. Bump set and four touches there for Les Carabins as McGill ties the score at 3. Genevieve Plante will now serve for the Martlets. And her jumper to middle six. And a quick set spike there by Les Carabins as Kelsey Irwin dumps it back over. And a right side hit coming there from Melanie Roy. But return fire from Victoria Pelletier goes just long. Her cross court hit could not find the tape there.
Both teams playing some aggressive volleyball right off the start. They're clearly eager to get off to a lead.
Definitely, we've seen very good back and forth. As you can see, the score is 4-3 for Les Carabins. And the serve's picked up by the libero. And Kelsey Irwin takes one to the floor. That one landed just below the attack line. Great spike there from Kelsey Irwin as she now goes to the line to serve. Great setup there by Daphne Maud-André Morin as she gave a perfect pass to Mansour, who was able to set up Kelsey Irwin with that nice attack. Melanie Wad just took that one line as McGill was unable to come up with the save off the dig. And Montreal takes a 5-4 lead. Marie-Sophie Nadeau will now serve for Les Carabins. She lines up for her jumper. And a powerful one down 5. And the dig there by Victoria Pelletier falls just over the net, and a little bit of confusion on the Carabins side as they let it just touch the ground.
Yeah, a bit of a lucky point for McGill, but they will certainly take it.
Emily Kite to serve now for the Martlets. Nice topspin serve picked up by the libero, Pellerin. And Pelletier handles that attack as she returns fire and uses catches the ball off the wipe. And Jaiva Mateus with another attack. Victoria Pelletier, but it's picked up by Les Carabins. And return fire blocked by McGill. Mansour to Pelletier. Pelletier tips it over. But the libero back set for Nadeau. And Pelletier picks it up in backcourt. Pelletier takes one to the ground. She split the block on that one. Right through the strong double block of Les Carabins. Great, great back and forth volleyball right there, Chris.
Excellent rally. That one went on for a while. Very exciting stuff.
Emily Kite to serve again for the Martlets. Six serving five. Float serve picked up in five. And a hard hit there coming from Sophie Bergeron, but handled by the Martlets. And Kelsey Irwin, with a strong backcourt attack, confused Nadeau there as she was unable to come up with a clean dig.
Big hit from Kelsey Irwin. Takes a lot of power to hit it that hard from the back row. She got all of that one.
Emily Kite serving again for the Martlets, seven serving five. She put a little too much pepper on that one as it soared just long. Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon will now serve for Les Carabins. And a short serve picked up by the Martlets. Geneviève Plante tried to get that one to Mansour, but it went a little bit too close to the net, and we were unable to recover on that one. Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon to serve again now. Picked up by Geneviève Plante. Outside set for Victoria Pelletier, but a huge stuff block there for Les Carabins. That was right back down on her head.
And that'll take us to our first technical timeout. The score is Montreal Carabins 8, McGill 7.
Some great back and forth volleyball there. McGill was starting to pull away with a 7-5 lead, but then Montreal came right back with 3 points and ended up taking McGill to the first timeout. So very back and forth game so far.
That's right. Montreal's rally came off of a miss serve from Emily Kite. McGill is going to have to work on their unforced errors. That's often an issue with this team. And it's very important that they don't lose points early.
Especially against a strong team like Les Carabins. You can't give them anything because they'll just take advantage on that and dominate you, because you won't see them making those errors. As we come back after the first technical timeout of the for Les Carabins. And still serving for Les Carabins is Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon. Picked up by Geneviève Plante. Mansour with the backcourt set for Kelsey Irwin. And a huge block up front there by Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc and Pamela Drapeau. They dropped that one right back on McGill. Vallée-Vachon still serving. Picked up by Geneviève Plante once again. And a back set there for Mateus. Kaiva Mateus took that one line. Great, great kill shot.
Beautiful shot there. That one couldn't have been much closer to the line.
Victoria Pelletier will now serve for the Martlets. 8 serving 9. Float serve picked up by the libero, Pellerin. And killed right back down on the Martlets. That's the thing, off a great pass like that from Pellerin, it's easy to get a nice set and a great kill, as was exemplified by Les Carabins right there. Martlets need to start picking holes with their serves. But there they go. They get the point right back on a miss serve there by Melanie Roy. It went just long. Kaiva Mateus to serve now for the Martlets. 9 serving 10. Nice serve picked up there by Bergeron and just stuffed. A quick stuff there by Maud Menard-Ouillet.
Tricky little play there. No Martlet was anywhere near that ball. No one saw that one coming at all.
Definitely a surprise. It's often a good tactic to just put a little tip in there once in a while, especially when you don't think the other team's expecting it. Sometimes it's better than a kill shot. Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc will now serve. Her jumper's good as it's picked up by Pelletier. And Kelsey Irwin returns fire with a quick little tip there. As we were talking about it earlier, sometimes the tip's all you need.
That's right. Variety is very important. You can't let the other team get to know your game and start predicting all your plays. It's very important to keep changing things up, and that's what we've been seeing here.
Mansour with a nice serve to 6. Picked up by André Morin. And Emily Kite there with a blocked shot. Geneviève Plante dumps it over. Set for Nadeau as she knocks it back over to the Martlet side. Emily Kite with a nice shot picked up by Le Carabin. And a tip picked up by Geneviève Plante. Mansour with the set. Plante with the kill picked up by Pellerin. And Kelsey Irwin takes one of the floor, but it was picked up by Pellerin again. And Nadeau knocks one into the net. What a way to end a rally. Great back and forth play there by both teams. Nadeau just knocked that one right into the net as she ended the rally on a kind of sour note there. But the Martlets get the point as they tie the game at 11. Nadeau with a huge shot right down the line. She stuffed that one. Marie-Sophie Nadeau had huge power behind that shot. Definitely coming from her height, the 6'1 power hitter. Pamela Drapeau now with the serve, picked up by Pelletier. Outside set for Emily Kite, off the block, picked up by André Morin. And Marcella Mansour just dumps it over quick. Nadeau returns fire, but it's picked up by André Morin. As Geneviève Plante dumps it over. And Les Carabins, some back and forth dump volleyball here. And there was a little bit of a foot on that ball, and the Martlets weren't able to come up with it. There was a little confusion. They were all jumbled together, and no one knew who was going for it.
Yeah, the Martlets were scrambling for positions there. Marcel Mansour tries to kick the ball. Not a great tactic.
Drapeau with another strong serve, but it was just long. Very close to catching the back corner.
Good call by the McGill player not to get a hand on that one.
Geneviève Plante now serving, 12 serving 13. Picked up by Valet Vachon. And Nadeau with a hard hit off the hands. And McGill was unable to come up with that. Maud Menard-Ouillet to serve now for Le Carabin, 14 serving 12. Serve picked up by Geneviève Plante. Pushed out for Victoria Pelletier, who nice cross-court hit. And Nadeau returns fire with a weak shot. Back to Pelletier. Hammers one off the hands of the libero, Pellerin. Great cross-court hit by number four, Victoria Pelletier.
Pellerin frustrated that she touched that one. Obviously disappointed in herself right after the play.
Kelsey Irwin to serve now for the Martlets. 13 serving 14. Picked up by Nadeau. Huge set and spike there. Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon got all of that one. Nadeau to serve again for Les Carabins as they take a 15-13 lead. Picked up by Geneviève Plante. Marcella Mansour back set for Emily Kite. Off the hands. She used the wipe on that one as it landed in the middle of two. Great offside hit there. Emily Kite serving for the Martlets. 14 serving 15. Picked up by Pellerin. And a big hit coming there from Melanie Roy as we reach the second technical timeout of the game.
Well, we're still seeing some very even back and forth volleyball here with a lot of really entertaining long rallies. The crowd is certainly into this one.
Yeah, we have quite a large crowd here tonight for this game. It's actually our last broadcast of the regular season, so we hope you'll tune into our playoff action.
That is assuming that the McGill Martlets make it into the playoffs, which they will if they win tonight.
If they win tonight, the Martlets only have to win one of their next four games to clinch that third and final playoff berth, so hopefully they can pull out the W tonight. If not, they'll have three more chances at it before the end of the campaign. So hopefully we'll be able to see you in playoff action. Once again, though, it was Les Carabins who took McGill into the second technical timeout with a score of 16-14. Montreal has forced both of the technical timeouts, so McGill, I'm sure, would like to take a lead once again in this game. Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon to serve now for Les Carabins. Strong serve goes just long as McGill gets the first point after that second technical timeout. 15-16 for McGill serving, and Victoria Pelletier will now serve for the Martlets. She lines up for her jumper. And a ace right there as it landed just short in six. She confused Nadeau, who was not sure if where that one was going to land.
First ace of the game for either team. As she lines up, let's see if she can do it twice.
Pelletier serving again as they're tied at 16. Nice, strong topspin serve. And a little bit of a joust at the net there. Paiva Mateus using her size to her advantage there as she beats out Les Carabins on that joust.
Yeah, Kaiva Mateus, the 6'1 player from McGill, tallest player on the McGill squad, using it there.
Great service there by Pelletier as she picks up her second ace of the game and second ace of this round of service. Great serving by Pelletier. As McGill gets four straight points there, forcing Les Carabins de Montréal to take a timeout.
Good decision by the Montreal coach. You don't want to let McGill, or any team for that matter, get on a roll. Momentum's a very important thing in volleyball. And Montreal's definitely going to come out of this and try to take back these 2 points immediately.
Especially when someone as strong as Victoria Pelletier is at the line serving. You definitely don't want her to continue on a roll. I mean, two aces and four serves, that's definitely, or three serves actually, that's definitely something you want to watch out for. So breaking her momentum is definitely a great idea by Coach Olivier Trudel. Pelletier with another strong serve, picked up there by Libero Pellerin. And an outside hit right there from Drapeau as she uses the wipe, and it the block off the block it goes just wide. Substitution for Les Carabins as Kim Beauregard-Lepage comes into the game, and she will serve for Les Carabins. At only 5'2", Kim Beauregard-Lepage is the smallest player on either team. And she clearly uses it there as she generates an ace, the first ace for Les Carabins. It's impressive when a player can come off the bench in a key situation like this and tie the game with an ace. Genevieve Plante knocking one into the block as Les Carabins take a one-point lead, 19 serving 18.
And McGill following suit, taking their first time out of the match, ensuring that Montreal can't run away with the score here late in the first set. We'd like to remind you that tonight's broadcast is brought to you by Domino's Pizza. Domino's Pizza, 514-845-2222. Call now, you can get your pizza before the start of the third set. Riley, you got your phone on you?
I do indeed, Chris.
Do you like pepperoni?
Oh, I sure do.
All right. Someone get Domino's on the line.
Our second half sponsor of tonight's matchup is also Ye Olde Orchard Pub and Grill. Head on over after the game for some post-game refreshments with three locations to serve you across Montreal at 5563 Monkland, 1189 Rue de la Montagne, and 20 Prince Arthur. We hope to see you there. Coming out of that timeout, Kim Beauregard-Lepage is still serving for Les Carabins as it's picked up by Genevieve Plante. And Kaiva Mateus splits the block as the Martlets respond, tying the game at 19. Definitely a good timeout call there by Rachel Beliveau as her Martlets were able to come out of that timeout and get the first point. Definitely a great side out there. Sophie Nadeau, hard hit picked up by Kaiser Mateus. But a double block there by Les Carabins, and they take one to the floor, shutting down the Martlets. Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc serving now for Les Carabins. Nice float serve picked up by Pelletier. And Nadeau uses her size to her advantage there, using her 6'1" stature to just put up a huge wall in front of the Martlets as they tried to tip it over, and she just slammed it right back down on their heads.
Yeah, great serve there by Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc, leading that point. McGill unable to cleanly handle the ball, and a quick hit by Nadeau seals the deal.
I'm sure Coach Rachel Beliveau is just telling her girls to be calm and to play their game because they definitely aren't out of it yet. Only 2 points behind as we've broken the 20-point marker. They can definitely still come back in this game, but it'll be tough against a squad as strong as Les Carabins. So we'll see how this one turns out. Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc serving for Les Carabins. Float serve picked up by Emily Kite and dumped over by Marcella Mansour. And a big set and attack by Nadeau, blocked by Mansour at the net. Another for Nadeau, picked up by André Morin as Pelletier gives it to Plante to dump it over. Back set for Drapeau. And Nadeau dumps it over again, picked up by André Morin. Marcella to Kelsey Irwin, who tips it over. Beauregard to Nadeau. Back to Beauregard. Dumped over by Bergeron. And Kelsey Irwin knocks one right into the huge double block of Les Carabins. Les Carabins using their size to their advantage at the net as they have both Marie-Sophie Nadeau and Pamela Drapeau at the net. 6 foot and 6'1" respectively. That's a lot of size at the net that they're using to their advantage. Great rally there, but with Montreal coming out on top, they now take a 22-19 lead as Bergeron serves. Picked up by Victoria Plante, Pelletier. Victoria Pelletier over to Mansour, to Genevieve Plante, who catches the line on her cross-court attack there. And McGill reaches the 20-point marker. Alexandra Shepherd is into the game for Mateus on the Martlet side as Mansoor serves. 20 serving 22. Mishandled there by Les Carabins as they dump it over, and Kelsey Irwin misplays it as well. But picked up by Andre Morin. Great pass, great set, nice attack by Genevieve Plante, and the Martlets get the point.
And we see Montreal take their second timeout. Both teams trying to play some mind games here, make sure that no one can build up too much steam. And when we come back from this, we'll see who can take the first set.
Definitely strong play from both sides, as you can see with the score, 22-21. Close fought match, as is the norm with these two teams. Both teams have a lot on the line tonight. McGill can clinch their final playoff berth, and Les Carabins, depending on how Laval does tonight, they can tie Laval for the first place in their RSEQ conference. So big games for both teams tonight. Marcella Mansoor still serving for the Martlets. Picked up by Pellerin. And a great set there by Ménard Houillette as she set up Mélanie Roy, Pamela Drapeau for a great kill shot. As Pamela Drapeau now goes to serve for Les Carabins. 23 serving 21. Float serve picked up by Pelletier. And Kelsey Irwin takes one off the hands. Great shot there. She wiped one off of Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon just to the right side, and great power. Great power there from Kelsey Irwin. Rebecca Canham coming in for the Martlets as she replaces Genevieve Plante, and she will serve. 22 serving 23. Great serve, picked up by Pellerin. And a backcourt attack, misfired there. Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc knocked one into the tape, and the Martlets tied at 23. Impressive play for Canem when you come off the court and get a key serve like that. Must feel great. Picked up by Bergeron. Nadeau, huge cross-court attack.
That one may have left a dent in the court. Huge hit by Nadeau.
Definitely using her power.
Our first set point of the evening comes for Montreal in this first set as they lead 24-23.
Emily Kite back into the game for the Martlets as she took off Alexandra Shepherd. Maud Ménard-Houillette to serve now for Les Carabins. Set point. And it's an ace, as there's a little bit of confusion there between Genevieve Plante, Emily Kite, and Kelsey Irwin. They let that one drop as there was a campfire ball right in front of all of them.
Very nice. Short serve there from LeBlanc, catching all the Martlets off guard. Great way to win the first set. Marie-Sophie Nadeau led her team with four kills in that first set. Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc and Kim Beauregard-Lepage also picked up an ace apiece. And for the Martlets, Kelsey Irwin led her squad with three kills. And Victoria Pelletier, the only Martlet to pick up any aces, she had two.
Take a break and join us.
We'll be taking a quick break, and we will be right back for the beginning of the second set.
Hello and welcome back to McGill Martlet Volleyball Tonight on SSN Canada. I'm Riley Wayman and I'm here with my broadcast partner Chris Wilhelm, and we're awaiting the start of the second set in tonight's matchup between the McGill Martlets and Les Carabins de Montréal.
That's right, Riley. The first set was won by Les Carabins de Montréal, 25-23 in a very hard-fought battle.
The Martlets get first serve in this match as Marcela Mansour goes to the line. Nice serve picked up by Les Carabins. Sophie Nadeau dumps one over, picked up by Mansour. André Morin dumps one back over. And Sophie Nadeau with a huge shot. But a great block there by Kelsey Irwin and Emily Kite as they send that one right back.
Kelsey Irwin, one of the few Martlets players who can stand up in height to Nadeau, being 6'0" herself against the 6'1" player.
And Nadeau with a nice tip, and the Martlets were unable to handle it as they dumped that one over on the wrong side of the antenna. And Les Carabins tied at one. Drapeau serving for Les Carabins as André Morin picks it up. Emily Kite, huge line shot there picked up by Melanie Roy. And return fire there by Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc as Les Carabins take a one-point lead early in this second set. Pamela Drapeau to serve for Les Carabins. Picked up by Victoria Pelletier. Emily Kite. Cross-court shot picked up by Nadeau. Dumped back over by the Martlets. Big set for Nadeau. Off the hands of the McGill block. Back to Nadeau. Picked up by André Morin as Genevieve Plante sprawls trying to keep it in, but she knocks that one into the stands. Great hustle and effort there by the Martlets.
Plante actually hit the stands a little bit, hopefully not too hard. She she looks like she was in a bit of pain after that collision.
Looks like she'll shake it off, though, as she stayed on the court. Nadeau to serve for Les Carabins. Picked up by Pelletier. Mansour with the set. Emily Kite with the kill as she knocks that one down the line. But It looks like it might have hit the antenna or gone just wide as Montreal pick up that point. A little bit of confusion there as the Martlets thought they had the point, but it was indeed Les Carabins. So it's 4-1. And now it's 5-1 with a big shot by Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon. Using her size at the net, she just stood there and one hand smack right back down.
McGill taking a timeout very early before we even reach the first technical timeout, as it is currently 5-1 for University of Montreal.
It's definitely a position that the Martlets didn't want to see themselves in, especially coming off that loss in the first set. I'm sure they were looking out to come out strong and show Les Carabins that they were really going to push hard for this set, but a 5-1 setback, not insurmountable, but definitely they have their work cut out for them if they want to come back.
That's right. As we said in our keys to the game, the McGill Martlets play a much stronger volleyball game all around when they're defending the lead and not trying to take one away from the opponent. They just seem to be more mentally aware. So McGill really does have their work cut out for them.
Marie-Sophie, oh, sorry, it's actually Pamela Drapeau serving for Les Carabins. Kelsey Irwin takes one to the floor as Drapeau got caught off guard there with the dig. Annie-Claude Pellerin, the libero, back into the game for Les Carabins, as Genevieve Plante serves for the Martlets. And she knocks that one into the net. There's a few boobirds in the crowd coming from l'Université de Montréal, and they were chanting Genevieve's name right there, so that could have had something to do with her poor serve. Marcella Mansour back to Kelsey Irwin. But she used the wipe to her advantage there as it looked like the Martlets got the point. Les Carabins thought they had that one with a nice block, but it was pushed just a little bit too far out of bounds, and the Martlets pick up the point, bringing them now 3 points behind at a 3-6 margin. Sophie Nadeau. Victoria Pelletier tried to come up with the dig there, but she dumped it a little bit too far for any of her teammates to reach, so Les Carabins will take the point. Nadeau serving for Les Carabins, and she knocks that one just wide. Emily Kite to serve now for the Martlets. 4-7. Picked up by Nadeau. Menard Ouyette with the set. And Melanie Roy with the kill. Cross-court attack there, bringing us to our first technical timeout of the second set.
Nice hit there by Melanie Waugh. That one was extremely close to being out. I personally thought it looked pretty out, but the referee right by it obviously had a much better look at it than I did, and it was in. So University of Montreal forces our first technical timeout. We've reached a score of 8-4.
The third time that Les Carabins have forced the technical timeout. All three, in fact, in this match so far have gone to Les Carabins, so they're clearly getting the early advantage in these games.
That's right. Mentally, it's a little disheartening to always be going into these timeouts. Your coach is always telling you how you have to come back into the game. You don't want to hear that. You want to hear how you can stay in the game. So, McGill, they're going to have to step things up a little bit if they want to keep competing, and they really do not want to lose this second set and be forced to win three in a row.
Definitely not, Chris. It's one thing to come back and split the set at 1-1, and then it's another thing to be down 2-0 and then having to come back. It's a lot easier to come back when you don't give them that two-set lead. Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon serving for Les Carabins as she knocks that one just long. And the Martlets get that point, bringing them now to 5 and Les Carabins to 8. Victoria Pelletier to serve for the Martlets. Picked up by Nadeau. Ouillette back to Roy. Ouillette to Drapeau to Roy. And she knocks that one way long. Martlets are within 2.
The entire McGill Martlets bench cried out on that one, making sure that no Martlet would get their hands on that. That was a pretty bad miss hit there.
Pelletier serving for the Martlets. Quick fire shot by Drapeau there. And Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc was able to bring that one, and with a nice line shot, she brings Les Carabins to 9 with a 3-point lead over the Martlets at 6. Mélanie Roy with a nice float serve to 6. Picked up, set by Marcella Mansour. And Genevieve Plante got the hands on that one as she gets a nice cross-court kill for the Martlets. Kaiva Mateus, number 14, serving for the Martlets. 7 serving 9. Float serve picked up by Nadeau. Ouillette over to Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc as she catches the backcourt line on that. Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc serving for Les Carabins. 10 serving 7. Her jumper, float jumper picked up by Pelletier there as Kelsey Irwin knocks one into the block and then dumps it over. Backcourt attack for Les Carabins as Nadeau gets the mitts up there for a nice stuff block on the Martlets.
Pretty impressive diving dig from Daphne Maud Andre Morin for McGill, but it's not enough to earn the point.
Bergeron. Jump serve to 6, picked up by Pelletier once again. And Kelsey Irwin takes one line. Great power there by Kelsey Irwin. Marcella Mansour to serve for the Martlets, 8 serving 11. Picked up by the libero, Pellerin. Push set for Nadeau, but a huge block by Emily Kite. Great stuff there. Especially coming off the hard-hitting Nadeau. That's definitely a beautiful block coming from Emily Kite. Mansour with the service to 6. Sophie Nadeau uses the wipe as she gets the point with that kill. Pamela Drapeau serving for Les Carabins, 12 serving 9. Picked up by Genevieve Plante. Backcourt set. Hit by Genevieve Plante. Ouillette to Roy. And with that dig there from Irwin, it touches the roof as Les Carabins get a break off of the McGill error on that one.
And with that, McGill will call. Look, their second timeout of this set, having taken one earlier when they were down 5-1. They are now down 13-9 as we are 3 points away from the next technical timeout. That is if Montreal gets the next 3 points. McGill continuing to play some catch-up volleyball. They're making some very impressive plays, good defense, good blocking, but they just can't seem to get ahead.
They seem to find themselves actually at the same losing margin as they were after they called their first timeout at 5-1. It's 13-9, so 4-point deficit that they have to overcome. Definitely they've been going back and forth, coming within a few points, but they're back down at four, and that's when Coach Rachel Bellivaud decides to call the timeout. Pamela Drapeau serving for Les Carabins de Montréal, 13 serving 9. Picked up by Genevieve Plante. Mansour with the set, Kelsey Irwin with the spike. Back to Genevieve Plante, finds a hole. And she made it count as an error called. An error called there on Les Carabins, as I think someone might have touched the net on that play. Genevieve Plante, nice service to six. Sophie Nadeau takes one to the line as she catches it there. Great power. Looked like the referee couldn't even see if that one was in or not. It was so quick, but he was able to make the call, calling that one in. The setter, Mogmena Rouillette, to serve now for Les Carabins. 14 serving 10. Float serve picked up by Plante. Backcourt set for Plante. At the net, Kelsey Irwin using her size as she dumps that one right back down. As she puts that away, it's her sixth point of the game as she will now go to the line to serve for the Martlets. 11 serving 14. Powerful serve picked up by Nadeau. And Emily Kite returns fire. Ouillette with the set. Nadeau with the smash. And she splits the block. And with the hands on that one, the Carabins de Montréal will get to point. 15-11. Emmanuelle Marin is in now for Les Carabins as she replaces Marie-Sophie Nadeau for the service. As she lines up for her jumper, it touches the tape, but it's still good. And Valet Vachon with a hard spike picked up by Mansour. Victoria Pelletier returns fire, but it's blocked. Emily Kite dumps it back over. Ouillette to Melanie Roy, picked up by André Morin for the Martlets. Trying to dump it back over, but it's blocked. Victoria Pelletier with some power, but it goes just long as it hits the opposing team's bench. Victoria Pelletier showing some great power on that, but definitely a little far as it goes into the Carabins' seating area as we reach the second technical timeout of the game.
That's right, McGill once again finding themselves on the losing end of things as we wait for this technical timeout. It's currently 16-11 for University of Montreal. McGill still playing some good volleyball, but they need to be a lot more consistent if they're going to get on top in this set.
Definitely a 5-point margin, especially after the second timeout. You're kind of second technical timeout. You're definitely losing ground when you're still down by 5 points at this point in the game.
That's right. It's going to be extremely important to close this gap as soon as this timeout expires. And we'll see both teams fighting very hard for these next few points, I'm sure.
Amy Graham is coming in for the Martlets as she replaces Victoria Pelletier. Emmanuelle Marin still serving for Les Carabins. A powerful jump serve, but it goes right into the tape as the Martlets get a break on that play. Emily Kite serving now for the Martlets. Picked up by Pellerin. Ouillette over for Bergeron, but her cross-court attack was just long as Emily Kite serves again for the Martlets. 13 serving 16. Picked up by Ouyette. And Bergeron with a nice attack. And a tip there by Marcel Mansour. Unable to come up with it was Le Carabin as McGill comes up with that play. You could see the frustration on Pellerin's face as she just was not expecting that little tip there. Emily Kite still serving for the Martlets, 14 serving 16. Ouyette with the set. Roy with the spike picked up by Genevieve Plante. And Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon puts up the huge block there as she stuffs the Martlets. With that block, Vallée-Vachon will now serve for Le Carabin. But it goes into the net as the Martlets come within two.
University of Montreal having a few serving issues here after this second technical timeout.
And you'll see they now call a timeout. I'm sure that Coach Olivier Trudel is probably going to be talking about that exact thing, Chris. Especially when you did have a 5-point lead, you can't be giving back points to the Martlets. Two service errors is unacceptable at this point in the game, especially in varsity university volleyball. I'm sure he expects better from his girls.
Oh, certainly. Both teams have some fans in the stands tonight, and these fans have been quite loud when players are serving, trying to psych them out. It seems to be working a few times anyways.
Definitely making themselves heard, especially that on the side of Le Carabin de Montreal. As you can hear right now, there's a few chants going on.
That's right, a very vocal minority here, causing some ruckus.
Amy Graham with a nice service. Genevieve Plante takes a nice shot into the hands of Pellerin. Bergeron with a big attack, dug nicely by André Morin, but it was coming in at such a force that it just went right up and touched the rafters in the gym. So that is out of bounds as Le Carabin de Montréal get the point, bringing them to 18. Roy with a nice serve picked up by Genevieve Plante, sorry. And another great block by Pamela Drapeau.
Pamela Drapeau leads the division in blocking with an average of 1.67 per game.
And Melanie Roy with that service error gave up the third error of the game of the set for Le Carabin de Montreal, and she will come out substituted for number 5, Audrey Lavallée. Kaiva Mateus to serve now for the Martlets, 16 serving 19. Picked up by Bergeron, and a big spike there by Pamela Drapeau as she takes that one line.
That's right. We should also mention that Pamela Drapeau also leads the division in hitting percentage with 0.37. Very impressive.
Marie-Sophie Nadeau is coming back in for Le Carabin as Emmanuel Marin goes off. Big spike there by the Martlets, but it's blocked by Le Carabin as Kelsey Irwin takes a cross-court shot off the hands of Audrey Lavallée.
7th point of the game for Kelsey Irwin.
Marcella Mansour to serve for the Martlets, 17 serving 20. Cross-court service picked up and there you go, Marie-Sophie Nadeau with one of her first errors at the net as she knocks that one right into the center of the net. Mansour to serve again for the Martlets. 18 serving 20. Picked up by Pellerin. Back set for Drapeau. And with a tricky little tip there, she knocks it over the heads of Genevieve Plante and Kelsey Irwin.
Yeah, we continue to see both teams getting caught off guard by those quick little tips. Everyone's prepared for these hard hits that we've been seeing, but...
Definitely a great maneuver there by Les Carabins as she lifted her leg, signaling she was going to jump for it, but she ended up with the tip. And with that kill there, Emily Kite goes cross-court. And 19 serving 21 as Genevieve Plante goes to the line. Jump serve. Great topspin on that serve. Picked up and hammered by Valet Vachon. Pancake. Marcella Mansour got the pancake, but Emily Kite, it was just too far for her to reach. Great effort there by the Martlets. Mélanie Roy coming back into the game for Les Carabins. Maud Ménard-Houillette serving for Les Carabins. And it's just long. Another service error for Les Carabins. I'm sure Coach Olivier Trudel is going to be talking to his girls about that after this set. Definitely unacceptable. McGill is catching some breaks here as they find themselves once again within 2 points. Kelsey Irwin, great service to the 5-6 seam. And a little bit of confusion between the refs as the head ref is calling a touch on behalf of Les Carabins on the net, and the linesman there calling, the other referee calling a no touch on that play. So a little bit of confusion, but it looks like McGill is going to come out on that side as they get the point. Bring them within one. It's 21 serving 22 as Kelsey Irwin takes the line. Float serve picked up by Nadeau. Nadeau, hard hit, but it's picked up by Plante and Emily Kite unable to handle it off the net.
Emily Kite misjudging where that ball was going to go after it hit the net. She just kind of looked at it, let it follow the ground.
Definitely, the net's a tricky player in this game. You never know where it's going to come off it. Marie-Sophie Nadeau to serve for Les Carabins. 23 serving 21. Picked up by André Morin. Mansour back set for Emily Kite. And she makes that one count. Great cross-court attack there.
Emily Kite making up for her previous transgressions as she slams that one cross-court to the ground. And Emily Kite finds herself subbed off as Alexandra Shepherd comes on to serve from the bench.
A lot of pressure coming in off the bench when there's within 2 points of the game point. And she comes up with a nice serve as the Martlets come with a nice block off of the shot from Melody Roy. Set. Bergeron with the tip. Genevieve Plante, backcourt attack. Ouillette to Sophie Nadeau with a backcourt attack. Mansour pushes one out and Graham off the hands. Ouillette over to Bergeron as she knocks one into the net. Great break for the Martlets as they tie the score at 23.
Timeout called by the Carabins as they attempt to stop McGill in their tracks, finding themselves tied at 23. Things just got a little more interesting here in the second set. For those viewers at home who may not have been tuned in at the time, the University of Montreal took the first set 25-23 in a hard-fought match. And McGill trying to rally here for a big comeback in the second set.
Definitely behind by four at both of the technical timeouts. McGill is now tied it at 23s, and for them to take this huge. Definitely they don't want to lose this and be down by two sets heading into the third set. It'll be a tough mountain to climb if that happens. And we'll see if they can close it out. As Alexander Shepherd is serving for the Martlets. Great. Hayes with a huge spike. Pellerin mishandled that ball as she dropped. Great service by Shepherd. And the Martlets do it. They come back to win the second set.
Great comeback there by the Martlets. This entire stadium is really bumping at the moment. Everyone's on their feet, cheering pretty loudly. The McGill Fight Band getting into the swing of things as the crowd's getting real excited here. So we have parallel sets. The Carabins took the first one, 25-23. And McGill coming right back to take the second set, 25-23. We're going to be taking a short break here as we have a bit of a halftime show. And we will be back to join you for the third set.
Hello and welcome back to McGill Martlet Volleyball tonight here at Donald Love Competition Hall, awaiting the start of the third set between the McGill Martlets and Les Carabins de Montreal. As just a little bit of a recap, Montreal took the first set 25-23 over the Martlets, and the Martlets came back with a come from behind victory at 25-23. So back-to-back 25-23 games here at Love Competition Hall. Les Carabins will serve first. And it is Sophie Bergeron-Leblanc. And a little bit of a joust at the net there. Won by Les Carabins, but the Martlets dump it over. And Nadeau with a huge hit, picked up there by Graham. Return fire by Kelsey Irwin. That was Kelsey Irwin's 11th kill of the game. Back, Marcella Mansour with a error on her service there. As Les Carabins tied at one early in this third set. Serving is Pamela Drapeau. Picked up by André Morin. Marcella Mansour to Kelsey Irwin, who knocks one into the block. Great kill shot there. As she makes her 12th kill of the game. Geneviève Plante to serve for the Martlets. Picked up by Bergeron. Dumped over. A little bit of net play here. Kelsey Irwin picking it up, and Graham fixes that one. Dumped over by Les Carabins. And the Martlets pick it up and dump it over. Sophie Nadeau hammers one off the net. And Emily Kite tries to dump it over. And she comes up with a tip there, which goes just wide as there is no touch on the play. Serving there was Maud Ménard-Ouillette. And Graham, Amy Graham, comes up with a nice shot there for the Martlets. Kelsey Irwin to serve for the Martlets. Three serving two early on in this third set. Powerful serve to middle six. Sophie Nadeau rolls one over. Kaiva Mateus. Quick hands off the block, picks that one up. And using her size, stuffs one down on top of Les Carabins. But a call is played as she had her hands over the net before the third touch. Before the third touch by Les Carabins. So Les Carabins will tie it at three. As Marie-Sophie Nadeau will serve. Picked up by Plante. Four touches there by the Martlets as Les Carabins celebrate that point for serving three. Marie-Sophie Nadeau serving once again. And she picks up an ace off of an error by Geneviève Plante. A little bit late to react as she thought Daphne Maud-André Morin was going to go for that one.
Geneviève Plante's getting a little banged up this game. She kind of fell on her head a little bit there. She ran into the stands earlier. She's going to have to take her easy.
Nadeau with the serve. Mansour with the set for Amy Graham. And Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon knocks one into the block and was unable to recover off of the stuffed block there from Kaiva Mateus. Kaiva Mateus with another block in tonight's match. Emily Kite serving for the Martlets, four serving five. And it goes long as Les Carabins pick up another point. The Martlets find themselves trailing once again early on in this third set. It's the third set in a row, in fact, that they've found themselves down by at least a two-point margin, approaching the first technical timeout. Mansour with the set. Kaiva Mateus tips one over and just out of bounds as Les Carabins bring their total to seven and the Martlets at four. Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon to serve for Les Carabins. Line shot picked up by André Morin. Kelsey Irwin backcourt attack picked up by Vallée-Vachon. Bergeron gets the kill after a mishandled ball by Kelsey Irwin. And Montreal reaches the first technical timeout of the third set with a four-point lead.
Yeah, we've seen that one before. McGill Well, we've been saying it the whole time. They have to ensure that they do not let Montreal run away with this thing early in the set. They did a great job mounting a comeback in the second, after the second technical timeout when they were down by four. But it's very taxing on your team to continually be recouping big leads. So both teams have a lot to fight for in these next few points.
Definitely. Coming out of the first technical timeout, Les Carabins de Montréal have a four-point lead as they are beating the McGill Martlets with a score of 8-4. Valet Vachon serving again, picked up by André Morin. Kaiva Mateus was blocked by Pamela Drapeau. But Amy Graham is able to split the block on that shot. Amy Graham will serve for the Martlets. 5-8. Picked up by Sophie Nadeau. And dumped over by Bergeron. Genevieve Plante got a bit of a bad jump off that one and Knox went straight into the block. Stuff block for Les Carabins as they take another four-point lead. 9-5. Mélanie Roy to serve for Les Carabins. Float serve to 5. Picked up by the Martlets. Genevieve Plante, huge attack, but is picked up by Pellerin de Libero. Back to Plante. Dumps one over. Another pickup. Dig by the libero. André Morin to Genevieve Plante. Backcourt set for Mélanie Roy. Picked up. Kaiva Mateus. Back to Genevieve Plante. And it's good. That one touched the line as the Martlets pick up a point.
Well, it took her about three hits, but she finally manages to pick up the point off the kill for Plante. Some great blocking there by the Montreal Carabins.
And that goes long. Oh, but there was a touch on that, apparently. Definitely a little bit of outrage there by Kelsey Irwin as they were called for a touch on a play that looked perfectly like a clean out, and a very upset Irwin. And she's going to go back and talk to the ref. Definitely upset on that call. I personally didn't see any touches on that, but what can you do? The refs have the final say, so.
That's
with
right.
That, Montreal will take another 4-point lead at 10-6. André Morin with a nice save there as the Martlets dump it back over. Great pickup by Amy Graham. Genevieve Plante dump rolls another one to Les Carabins. Sophie Nadeau comes up with a shot. Marcella Mansour to Kelsey Irwin, and she makes it count. That's the best thing to do after a call like that from a ref. You just take it and use your frustration to pound one out on the court. Great spike from Kelsey Irwin.
That's right. You just have to move on mentally. Don't let these things affect you. Get right back into the game.
Mélanie Roy rolls one over. And Kelsey Irwin takes another one to the floor. Definitely picking up steam. 14th K of the game for Kelsey Irwin. Marcella Mansour to serve now for the Martlets. Float serve picked up by Pellerin. Nadeau with a bit of a sidearm attempt. But the Les Carabins are called with four touches. Marcella Mansour to serve again for the Martlets. Picked up by Pellerin. Sophie Nadeau. Diving Marcella Mansour comes up with that ball. Back to Sophie. Marie-Sophie Nadeau comes up with another huge kill shot down the line.
Marie-Sophie earning herself a few calls from her fans in the stands here as the boys in blue make themselves heard.
For their size, the Les Carabins, the Montreal, their fans are definitely louder than the McGill fans at this moment. But with that, the Martlets come up with a nice point off of the hands of Emily Kite with a great tip there. Genevieve Plante to serve for the Martlets. 10 serving 11. Dumped over there by Ménard Rouillette. Great heads-up play by the setter for Les Carabins. She saw an opportunity and she made it count. The Martlets were playing very tight against the net, and Ménard Rouillette saw the deep empty space in backcourt and she just shot a nice deep volley. Amy Graham and Sophie, Marie-Sophie Nadeau comes up with a nice counterattack as she was able to split the block and take the point on that play. 13 serving 10. Maud Ménard Rouillette still serving for Les Carabins. Picked up by Plante. Back to Amy Graham. Off of the block. Marcella Mansour back set. Emily Kite splits the block. Picked up by Pellerin. To Bergeron. To Sophie Nadeau. Back. Emily Kite. Her tip comes up a little short as Les Carabins are up by four. And that will lead Rachel Beliveau to call a timeout for the Martlets.
Well, just a little recap for you folks at home who may not have been tuned in the entire match tonight. Our first set was taken by Les Carabins of Montreal, 25-23 in a very close match. McGill coming right back in the second set to take it 25-23 as well. McGill found themselves down by 4 points at both the technical timeout points in that second set, but managed to rally near the end, tying it at 23 and then eventually taking the last 2 points. It's currently 14-10 for the University of Montreal. As we are here in the third set, and we are just about to get back underway after that timeout taken by McGill.
After that timeout, the Martlets find them down by 4 points. Ball picked up by Andre Morin. Emily Kite with a nice shot down cross court. Amy Graham knocks one into the block. And Emily Kite dumps one over. Picked up by Valet Vachon. Back set for Melanie Roy. And a big dig there by Genevieve Plante. Ricocheted off of Marcella Mansour and went right into the net, and it looked like Amy Graham was unsure whether or not the refs were going to call a double touch on that, so she wasn't sure if she could play it, but it looked like she could have made the play. Genevieve Plante for Marcella Mansour. Kelsey Irwin with another shot. Great quick sets there from Marcella Mansour, and she takes that one down the line. That was her 15th kill of the game.
Kelsey Irwin playing a fantastic game of volleyball tonight. Yet, her McGill Martlets find themselves down by four.
11 serving 15 as Irwin has a nice serve to the 5-6 seam. And they get lucky as Les Carabins dump it just wide. Martlets still serving trademark number 9, Kelsey Irwin. Melanie Roy tries to take that one, but there was four touches called by the referee. Clearly lit a little bit of confusion on behalf of Les Carabins there, as they were called for four touches without even noticing. And Kelsey Irwin gets charged with a misserve there as the Les Carabins reach the second technical timeout at a score of 16-13.
Did they give you any back?
And we are back after that short little break for our second technical timeout here in the third set. University of Montreal leads this set 16-13. And they are going to make a substitution here as number 2, Melanie Ferrand, comes in. And number 13, Marie-Sophie Nadeau, takes a seat on the bench for the time being.
Melanie Ferrand will serve now for Les Carabins. Her serve is good as it's picked up by Amy Graham and dumped over by Emily Kite. Clearly, Annie-Claude Pellerin was not pleased with that as she came up short and ended up kicking the ball all the way down the court.
Not a bad kick. She could have a career in soccer after this match is over.
She might, Chris. She might. Alexandra Shepherd serving now for the Martlets. Nice serve to 5 as she makes a nice dig there. Genevieve Plante splits the block. And Bergeron slams one into the net as the Martlets come up with another point and are now within one. Alexandra Shepherd serving again for the Martlets, 15 serving 16. Picked up by Les Carabins, and Bergeron dumps one over. Amy Graham knocks one off the block.
Some more great blocking by Montreal. They've been putting up a very formidable defensive wall all night, and McGill continues to hit balls right into them.
Definitely using their size to their advantage, putting up some of their tallest players at the line there. McGill comes up with it, and Amy Graham rolls a shot just long as Les Carabins take a 3-point lead. And with that, the Martlets call another timeout.
As we've been seeing all game, anytime a team goes down by about 3 or 4 points in a row, they will call a timeout right away. Make sure that the other guys can't build up any steam and let things really get out of hand. It's currently 18-15 for University of Montreal here in our third set at G. Donald Love Competition Hall here at McGill University. We'd just like to remind you that this game is brought to you by our sponsors, Domino's Pizza, 514-845-2222. Call now and you can get your pizza before the end of the game. It's some great pizza. Also brought to you by Ye Olde Orchard Pub and Grill, Official after party of McGill Martlets Volleyball. We hope to see you there after the game with 3 locations to serve you across the island of Montreal.
Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon serving now for Les Carabins, 18 serving 15. Kaiva Mateus dumps one over. Ouillette with a nice set for Bergeron. She uses the wipe to her advantage. Substitution for the Martlets as Victoria Pelletier is coming back in for Amy Graham. Looks like Coach Rachel Beliveau is looking to use Pelletier's power as we reach the second half of this set. Ballet Vachon set Marcella Mansour to Kaiva Mateus, and she finds a hole as that one was good. Victoria Pelletier serving now for the Martlets. And off a quick set there, Pamela Drapeau takes one to the floor. Montreal has reached the 20-point marker, and McGill had a 4-point deficit at 16. Audrey Lavallée serving now for Les Carabins. Service is good, picked up by Victoria Pelletier. Unfortunately, she got a little too much on her dig, and it went right over and onto the hands of Pamela Drapeau, and she nailed one right back down the Martlet's throat. Amy Graham back into the game for Victoria Pelletier. And she picks one up. Kaiva Mateus calling for that one, and she makes it count.
Quick hit there. Nice set there made by Marcella Mansour. Kaiva Mateus makes no mistake hitting that one to the backcourt.
Mateus serving now for the Martlets, 17 serving 21. And Bergeron with a massive spike right down the line right there, bringing the Les Carabins within 3 points of closing this third set.
That's right, Montreal answering immediately with a hard hit of their own. And Miguel needs to be very careful as they only have 3 points to lose this set.
Bergeron, picked up by Amy Graham, and Genevieve Plante with a big spike there into the dig of Les Carabins. They couldn't come up with a set off of that. Emily Kite back into the game for Alexander Shepherd. And for Montreal, Marie-Sophie Nadeau is coming back into the game for Melanie Ferrand. Coming out of the substitutions, Marcella Mansour will serve for the Martlets. Great float serve picked up by Pellerin, and Kelsey Irwin knocks one right back. Return fire from Marie-Sophie Nadeau as she knocked that one off of the hands of the dig and out of play. Great play by Nadeau to pick up that point. Pamela Drapeau to serve for Les Carabins de Montréal. Her jump serve at the 1-6 seam. Quick set from Marcella and a quick hit from Kelsey Irwin, but unfortunately just wide as Pamela Drapeau will serve again for Les Carabins, serving for the set point here. And her jump serve is good, picked up by Genevieve Plante. Quick set for Kelsey Irwin, and she makes that one count. You could hear her calling from that one all the way up in the stands. She definitely knew that she could find a hole, and she did.
That was Kelsey Irwin's 16th point of the game. She's having a very, very good night.
And once again, Rebecca Canam sees herself coming in right at the wire to make a crucial serve here for the Martlets. And it's good. Picked up by Pellerin. Over to Sophie Nadeau, who knocks it long. Canam working her magic, bringing the Martlets back within four.
She does seem to be a bit of a lucky charm for McGill. Often coming off the bench to serve and picking up a few points usually.
And after that timeout, Rebecca Canem will serve once again for the Martlets, 20 serving 24. Coming up with another nice serve once again. Big back set for Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon, and she couldn't come up with it. Maud Ménard-Houillette lost a bit of her touch on that set as it went. She pushed it a little too far back for Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon, and the Martlets are within three. Ouillette to Sophie Nadeau, picked up by Canam. Marcella Mansour over for Amy Graham, roll shot, picked up by Pellerin. Sophie Nadeau drops one, picked up by Kelsey Irwin. Over for Emily Kite, who dumps it quick. Vallée-Vachon, Sophie Nadeau, and a sprawling Rebecca Canam could not come up with that as Montreal closes the third set 25-21. Great rally there to end that game.
Very exciting. McGill just unable to be consistent enough to take 5 points at the end there. It's a very difficult task. And with that, the Montreal Carabins will take the lead in this match, having won two sets so far. They won the first set 25-23. And this third set 25-21, McGill took our second set 25-23. We're going to take just a quick break here as we wait for the beginning of the fourth set.
Hello and welcome back to McGill Martlet Volleyball tonight on SSN. Awaiting the start of the fourth set. And just a little bit of a recap. The Les Carabins de Montréal took the first set 23-25, and McGill came back to take the second set 25-23, but the Les Carabins came back in the third and won it by a 25-21 differential. So coming into this fourth set, Les Carabins have a 2-1 lead in sets. A key for the Martlets in this set is definitely going to be to come out strong right from the beginning. They've found themselves trailing at the beginning of each of the previous sets, being the trailing team heading into the first and actually second technical timeouts. So we'll see if they can come out with a strong first part of this set. And right off the bat, Les Carabins come out with a 1-point lead off of that nice spike by Gabriel Vallée-Vachon. Serving now for Les Carabins is Gabriel Vallée-Vachon. As it's picked up by André Morin, Marcel Mansour with the set. Kelsey Irwin with the kill. As Vallée-Vachon was caught way back and out of position, she was unable to come up. Serving now for the Martlets is Geneviève Plante. Picked up by Pellerin. Big set for Bergeron. And an even better dig as the Martlets return fire. Kelsey Irwin picks up another kill shot in tonight's matchup. She's been crucial for the Martlets tonight, for sure. Geneviève Font serving again, two serving one. Picked up by Nadeau. Set for Bergeron again. Picked up by Plante. And Amy Graham knocks one off the tape. Point Les Carabins.
We have a few fans heckling each other here in the stands as things get heated up in this game.
Picked up by André Morin. Back set for Emily Kite as she takes that one cross court. Kelsey Irwin to serve for the Martlets. And a ball rolled onto the court, so there will be a little bit of delay, but Irwin will serve now. Three serving two. Float serve picked up by Nadeau. And a quick dump there from Maynard Ouillette as she did a nifty move there to catch the Martlets off guard.
Very nice reactionary play there. No one expected that one.
Bergeron knocks one wide. Sorry, long. Continuing with the service errors for Les Carabins. I'm sure Coach Olivier Trudel will have to talk to his girls about that. He's definitely not pleased about giving up points, especially undeserved points like that one. Picked up by Pellerin. Back set for Pamela Drapeau. Kaiva Mateus. And backcourt for Geneviève Plante. At the line, Sophie Nadeau picked up by Amy Graham. Back to Amy Graham, and she knocks that one off of the block and too far for the libero, Pellerin, to pick up. Emily Kite will serve once again for the Martlets. Five serving three. Picked up by Marie-Sophie Nadeau. And she comes up with a big spike, but it's into the tape as the Martlets take a 6-3 lead.
McGill finding themselves in the best position they've been in early in any set here. Poised to go into the first technical timeout with the lead for the first time.
Definitely strong start for McGill, something that I'm sure Coach Rachel Beliveau was looking for. Back set from Ouellette. And Sophie Nadeau just drops one right at the attack line. And the Martlets were not prepared to come up with a dig on that play. Pamela Drapo to serve for Les Carabins. Picked up by Amy Graham. Andre Morin dumps it back in, and Kelsey Irwin dumps it over. Maynard Ouellette dumping it back, and Kaiva Mateus with the quick tip for the Martlets. Sophie Nadeau comes cross court. Genevieve Plante did not see where that ball was, and she did not. She could not run for it and keep the ball in play.
I'm not sure even if she saw that one, if she'd be able to get to it in time. It was pretty far away.
That's true, Chris. To serve once again for Les Carabins is Pamela Drapeau as she goes for her jumper, which is good, but diving Genevieve Plante is able to dump it over, and she dives again, and Mansour tips it over. Back set and spike for Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon as she takes that one cross.
Kelsey Irwin looking uncomfortable as she's unable to handle that one. Very nice hit from Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon.
Pamela Drapeau at the line for Les Carabins, who have tied it at six. Picked up by Genevieve Plante, and she's able to stuff that one through the block as the Martlets take it to seven. Martlets determined to be the first team to this first technical timeout for the first time this game, this match. So we'll see if they can do it. Amy Graham. And they do with that spike from Gabrielle Vallée-Vachon that goes right into the net. At our first technical timeout, McGill is leading with a score of 8-6.
It's got to be a pretty big confidence booster for McGill. Having lost that last set after coming back in the second, they need something here. And they've proven that they are able to take the lead early. If they can hang on, they have a very good chance in the fifth. Well, we have almost a full house here tonight of very excited McGill fans and a couple of Montreal Carabins fans as well. They've been making a lot of noise this game. It's been a very exciting match. I don't blame them.
That's for sure, Chris. Definitely some great volleyball here tonight. And once again, a word from our second half sponsor, Ye Old Orchard Pub and Grill. Head on over after the game for some post-game refreshments with three locations to serve you across Montreal at 5563 Monkland, 1189 Rue de la Montagne, and 20 Prince Arthur. We hope to see you there. Amy Graham to serve for the Martlets after that first technical timeout, 8 serving 6. Jump shot, good. Picked up by Sophie Bergeron. Picked up by Amy Graham for the Martlets. And a big shot by Genevieve. Plante goes off the hands and back onto the Martlets side. The serve, the setter, Maud Ménard Ouellette, will now serve for Les Carabins. 7 serving 8. Great serve there, picked up by Amy Graham. And Kelsey Irwin dumps one long. Great dig from Amy Graham off of a huge shot from Melanie Roy. And Marie-Sophie Nadeau is able to find a hole as Genevieve Plante takes some more abuse from the floor.
That's right. Plante is not afraid to go for those hard-to-reach shots. She's made some impressive diving saves already tonight. That one, not so lucky.
Definitely a quality, I'm sure, Coach Rachel Beliveau looks for in a player. Someone who's down to get down and dirty and get the job done. Marie-Sophie Nadeau with another kill for Les Carabins. as they have now taken the lead. 9-8. Maud Menaru yet serving again for Les Carabins. She knocks that one off the tape. But good. And the Martlets called on a lift violation. And Les Carabins will make it to 10.
The Martlets, who did a great job getting to that first technical timeout before Montreal could, have now given up 3 straight points. They need to get their heads back in this game.
Oh, and Amy Graham was unable to come up with that off of the service, and it was a tic-tac-toe effect, and none of the Martlets could come up with a nice pass.
No surprise here. McGill calling their first timeout of this fourth set as they find themselves down 11-8.
Timeout. It is Montreal with 11, McGill with 8, and Maud Menaruyet is still serving for Les Carabins. She lines up for her jumper, and it's good to 6. Quick set for Kaiva Mateus. Dumped over by Nadeau, and it was dumped just a little bit too long. And that one is just out on the right side, on the left side. Kaiva Mateus to serve for the Martlets. Picked up by Nadeau. And a quick set for Valet Vachon. Picked up by the Martlets and dumped over by Genevieve Plante. A nice turning spike there. And she takes it line. Kaiva Mateus serving again, 10 serving 11. Ouyet to Nadeau, picked up by Mateus. Backcourt for Amy Graham, picked up by Pellerin. Back to Nadeau, and she takes that one to the ground, right between the hands of Amy Graham.
Nadeau has an extremely hard shot. It's very, it's kind of hard to track sometimes. She's doing a great job of hitting him straight to the floor.
Marie-Sophie Nadeau. And she gets lucky as she knocks one into the net. But it just dribbles over and lands right on the line. With that ace, Marie-Sophie Nadeau brings Montreal's point tally to 13, McGill's to 10. Emily Kite with the dig, hammered by Genevieve Plante. Backcourt for Sophie Nadeau, picked up by Amy Graham. Set from Marcella. Kelsey Irwin couldn't close it, but she comes back and takes one cross court. That's 18 kills on the night for Kelsey Irwin. Great performance. Marcella Mansour serving for the Martlets. Picked up by Pellerin. Pushed out for Bergeron, who takes a hard cross-court hit and off the hands of André Morin.
Not much chance there for André Morin. She's normally extremely solid on the defensive digs, but just a little bit too much power on that shot for her to handle.
Valet Vachon served that. And Pamela Drapeau at the net pushes that one, and it catches the line as she comes up with a nice block. using her 6 foot stature to her advantage there. Picked up by Amy Graham. Marcella to Kelsey Irwin. Big shot. Olivier Trudel clearly not pleased with that play, as he's having a little word with Bergeron over there. 10, Geneviève Plante to serve for the Martlets. Picked up by Bergeron. Ouillette over to Mélanie Roy. Picked up by Emily Kite. Amy Graham with the sideways roller. And she makes that one count as the Martlets come within two. 13 serving 15.
Really impressive hit there from Amy Graham. She was facing the opposite direction from the net. She had to turn and hit that one. She hit it with a lot of accuracy, a lot of force.
Geneviève Plante with a nice serve for the Martlets. Kelsey Irwin, quick set, picked up by Pellerin. Back for Nadeau, backcourt attack. Emily Kite comes up, but it's picked up again by Nadeau. Push up for Bergeron. Knocks one off the net, picked up by Graham. Backcourt set, hit by Graham. Ouillette, Bergeron off of the net, picked up by André Marin. And Kelsey Irwin takes a cross-court shot, makes it count, 19th kill of the game. Sorry, actually that's her 20th kill shot of the game. Geneviève Plante, picked up by Marie-Sophie Nadeau, and hammered. It was out by Mélanie Roy, but picked up by Mansour. And then the Martlets get called on the line right there. Unfortunate turn of events for the Martlets. Sometimes when you're on the court and in the middle of a rally, it's difficult to tell where the lines are. So Marcella Mansour played that ball, and the Martlets unfortunately got caught with their own long ball on the other end of the court.
Well, that's right. If you're unsure if the ball's going to go out or not, it's generally best to just take a shot at it. If you have a good shot, that's what she did. But McGill making the same mistake the Carabins made and not getting quite as lucky.
Definitely. So the Martlets find themselves down by two as we've reached the second technical timeout of the game. Interesting to see. They did manage to make it first out of the first technical timeout, but they are now trailing by 2 points after the second.
Well, that's better than the usual 4 points that they're trailing by the second technical timeout.
That's true. A little bit of a mid-game collapse for the Martlets, but still a strong performance so far. I'm looking forward to seeing how the rest of this set plays out.
It's sure to be very entertaining, Riley.
Mélanie Roy serving for Les Carabins. In fact, number five, Audrey Lavallée, will take Mélanie Roy's spot as she will serve for Les Carabins. 16 serving 14. Picked up by André Morin. Kelsey Irwin knocks the ball just long as it's a point for Les Carabins. Picked up by Geneviève Plante. Kelsey Irwin. Picked up by Pellerin. And Bergeron with a huge cross-court attack. Takes that one to the floor. And off that play, McGill will take a timeout as they trail by four.
Three-point losses in a row for McGill. Two of those unforced errors as they hit them long. You just cannot afford that kind of play this late in the game. They have to dig deep here if they want to come back in this set, and even deeper if they want to come back in the match and take the fifth.
Definitely. It's do or die here for the Martlets. They do not want to see themselves down by any more than four in this match. We've seen them come back before as was shown in the second set. So they definitely, I would not count them out of the match or the set so far, but they definitely have their work cut out for them again. Audrey Lavallée to serve again for Les Carabins, 18 serving 14. Picked up in one by the Martlets. Kelsey Irwin, big shot, and she manages to get that one around the block. As a matter of fact, right into the block, and it rode their bodies down to the floor. With that kill, Kelsey Irwin will now serve, 15 serving 18. Nice floater. And picked up, kept alive by Amy Graham. Knocked over by Kaiva Mateus, and Pellerin will dump it deep. Marcella Mansour for Kaiva Mateus, and she managed to hit that one right at the 3-meter line. McGill cutting Montreal's lead in half. Kelsey Irwin, 16 serving 18. Great serve, picked up by Nadeau, but she couldn't get it to anyone, as Irwin will be credited with an ace on that play. And with those three consecutive points, Montreal will call a timeout. Definitely great volleyball there by the Martlets. As I said, we should never count them out, and they proved me right there, as they are now within 1 point of the leading Carabins.
That's certainly true. They have a habit, though, of taking one step forward, two steps back. They're going to have to stay very focused. Kelsey Irwin has to come out, continue to keep making some good serves, and force Montreal to play on their heels.
After that timeout, Kelsey Irwin still serving for the Martlets, 17 serving 18. And her floater's good, picked up by Pellerin. And Bergeron is blocked at the line. Bergeron returns fire, but another big block by Kaiva Mateus. For Pellerin, she dumps it deep, picked up by Genevieve Plante. Marcel Mansour, Kaiva Mateus, picked up by Pellerin. Over to Bergeron, picked up by Genevieve Plante. Mansour backcourt. Emily Kite takes it to the floor. Great back and forth ball there by both teams, but McGill comes up with it and has tied the game at 18s. Irwin still serving for the Martlets. Another great serve to five, picked up. Genevieve Plante keeps it in, and dumped over by Mateus. Bergeron, strong cross-court attack. And that one, she made that one count for sure.
No mistake there, very nice hit. Solid right to the back corner.
Bergeron definitely picking up steam in this game. Her power has been increasingly deadly as this match has gone along. Bergeron picked up by Genevieve Plante, dumped over by Kite. And Nadeau, strong shot. McGill calling no hands on that play, and it was just long, so the Martlets will get the point and tie it at 19.
The Carabins really excited after that point. We saw them all look over at the referee as he pointed his hands towards the Martlets. A look of disgust crossed their faces.
Substitution for the Martlets as Alexander Shepherd comes back into the game to serve for up to six, picked up by Pellerin, pushed out for Nadeau. And André Morin was a little bit out of position as that ball went right off her hands and out of bounds. With that, Pamela Drapeau will come up to serve for Les Carabins. And she knocks that one wide. Montreal gets a lucky error there. Montreal has an error there, and McGill gets lucky as they tie it at 20. Definitely back and forth ball here as it's gone from 18s, 19s, and now 20s. So Amy Graham will serve for the Martlets. Picked up by Pellerin. Ouellette pushes one out for Nadeau. Off the hands. There is definitely a touch there. No doubt about it as Les Carabins come up with a point. Mélanie Roy coming in to replace Audrey Lavallée. Maud Ménard-Ouillette will serve for Les Carabins. And that one's into the net. Back-to-back service errors for Les Carabins, bringing McGill right back into it at 21s.
Well, we've been saying it all game. These service errors are starting to rack up. McGill within striking distance of this fourth set. They just have to take 4 points here.
Mateus with a nice serve to five, picked up. And Nadeau with a great spike, but it's blocked by Kelsey Irwin. Another great block by the Martlets, but Mélanie Roy was able to use the block to her advantage as she wiped that one off. Mélanie Ferron coming in for Marie-Sophie Nadeau to serve here late in the fourth set. 22 serving 21. Picked up by André Morin. Marcella Mansour, Genevieve Plante. Rocket of a shot, way wide.
Yeah, no control demonstrated on that shot. As we see that one sail wide, McGill finding themselves down by two, 23 to 21.
Mélanie Ferron still serving. And once again, another missed serve from Les Carabins. By the look on Olivier Trudel's face, he is not happy. He's shaking his head. He can't believe what is happening. Giving McGill second life, Marcella Mansour will serve, and Emily Kite is back on the floor for the Martlets. Marcella Mansour serving, 22, serving 23. A lot of pressure here. And it's good. Picked up by Pellerin. Ouellette pushes one out for Bergeron, and she goes long. Almost caught the corner, but great eyes by the Martlets there as the game is tied at 23. And Olivier Trudel will call a timeout for Les Carabins. Definitely a tight match here. I mean, exactly what the Martlets wanted to do was to come back and play a great game. They've capitalized on some errors from Les Carabins, and they're going to try and take this match to five sets.
Yeah, Montreal definitely wanting to avoid that at all costs. Both teams 2 points away from taking this fourth set. A lot on the line here as the excitement is mounting. McGill hoping to win this match and secure a playoff spot, while Montreal is hoping to win and tie Laval for first place in the division.
After that timeout, Mansour still serving, 23 serving 23. And it's good. Picked up by Bergeron. She lines up for her attack. And it's good. Right along the line. Amy Graham had no chance. Very powerful hit by Bergeron. She got all of that one. Martlets once again see themselves down by a 23-24 margin as Les Carabins try to shut down the match. Kim Beauregard-Lepage in for the final serve. Oh, and it's picked up by Amy Graham. It looked like it might have been going out. Emily Kite and a great block by Melanie Wah for Les Carabins as they shut the door on the Martlets' hopes. Another very close game and match here at Love Competition Hall. That set going to Les Carabins de Montreal, 25-23.
That's right. So just a recap of our game. University of Montreal took our first set 25-23. McGill came storming back in the second with a great comeback to take that set 25-23. The Carabins in the third playing a little more strongly, taking it 25-21. And now in the fourth, they win 25-23 to seal the deal on this match. Some players of note in tonight's game for the Montreal Carabins. Marie-Sophie Nabdo had 11 kills in this match and one ace, leading her team. And Kelsey Irwin for the McGill Martlets, she is our player of the game with 21 kills and an ace to her name. She had an extraordinary night. Unfortunately, it wasn't a rally back from their early losses. And McGill finds themselves on the losing end of this one.
They'll hope to win one of their next three games in order to solidify their playoff berth in the RSEQ conference. Our next McGill SSN broadcast is Martlets and Redmen basketball, Friday, February 4th at 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. Love Competition Hall. Martlet Hockey on Saturday, February 5th at 7 p.m. at McConnell Arena. And Martlet's volleyball playoffs begin February 11th. Hopefully, the Martlets will be present in those playoffs. A final word from our sponsors. The second half of tonight's match was brought to you in part by Ye Olde Orchard Pub and Grill. Head on over now for some post-game refreshments with three locations to serve you across the island of Montreal at 5563 Monkland, 1189 Clou de la Montagne, and 20 Prince Arthur. Also, the halftime was brought to you in part by Domino's Pizza, the official pizza of McGill Athletics. I sure did enjoy my Domino's Pizza at halftime. You can still call at 514-845-2222 to order yours now. On behalf of myself, Riley Wayman, my broadcast partner, Chris Wilhelm, and the entire SSN Canada crew, we thank you for watching and bid you good night.